think about us. And I think about the day I got a wrap around your finger. I think about us. The sun was shining on you. The Lord was smiling. And I can't get over you.
word of God, according to St. John, says, let not your heart be troubled. He believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions, and if it were not so, I would have told you. Behold, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there he may be also. Bow your heads with me. Father, the God of all comfort and peace, the one who gives peace that this world cannot take away, we come before you this morning, not in a circumstance that we wish that we would be here, God. It's a morning that parents don't want to be here, and siblings don't want to be here. A husband does not want to be here, God. Family and friends wish we were not gathering for this. But Lord, it's the reality of man. It's the reality of destiny. And so as we come who are remaining, God, pray that your peace will be with us through this service. Give strength where strength fail, God. Give peace where heart is hurting and broken. Simply because we mourn with hope. We mourn with hope, Jesus. And we thank you even now for hearing us. In Jesus' name, amen. Be seated for a few moments. My name is Miranda Lal, and I'll be your officiating minister. I want to thank those who are here. Thank you very much for coming. And for those who are watching online, I'm happy that you're able to join us. Wherever you're watching from, wherever you're joining from, we're so grateful that you're all here virtually and in person to celebrate the life of Vanessa James Jade Simone Nelson. We're grateful that you're thinking about her. And so as we go through this service, we know it is not an easy one. It's not an easy one for parents and siblings and a husband. It's not an easy one for family and for friends. But I challenge you that we think about Vanessa. We think about the moments that you would have had with her, the time that you shared with her, the moments that you laughed together, you cried together, the proud moments that you had with her. Because from here out, that's basically what we have to bring around with us. Her memories, the times that we spent with her, shared with her, and journeyed with her. And so in celebrating her life, I invite you to join with me in singing this great hymn of the faith, Great is Thy Faithfulness. The family can remain seated if they so desire to, but I invite the rest of the congregation to stand with me as we try to sing it together. Great is thy faithfulness. Stand with me, please. I think we'll be accompanied by that's it.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not, thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Oh, pardon for sin and a peace that endureth, thine own dear presence to cheer and to
Thank you. Remain standing for the word of God that comes to us from Romans chapter 8, verses 38 and 39. And it reads, "For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature, created things, shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus." Please be seated. I met with Dwight and Michelle as we prepared for today and realized how great of a parents they are, and they were to Vanessa, or to their children. And so at this time they'll be coming with Vanessa's siblings. They'll be coming to share a tribute, and then we'll come back and do that second hymn. So can you come at this time, please? Thank you.
Wow. Good morning, everybody. So when we were asked to do our tributes, we thought of three words that best represent our Vanessa: light, love, life. No parent should have to bury their child. And we thank everyone for the condolences, the support, and the love that you have provided to us. So before I start, I want to say thank you. Life. Vanessa was born January 17th, 1991. For some of you who know her well, she was an overdue baby. She didn't want to come out. And she would want me to tell you this story because this is about her life. She was about 3-4 weeks overdue. When she found out that I was going to be induced, she came into this world. And she blessed us and several people that she's touched with her life and her words and her inspiration. light. Anyone who has met our Vanessa knew she was a beacon of light. On the days that you felt sorrow, or you just felt you couldn't go that extra distance, Vanessa gave you that push. That was the light that we want everyone here to remember. Okay? Love. For the longest, our Vanessa would constantly wonder, when will I find that love? I want nothing less than what my parents have. And when she found love, she embraced it. She encouraged it. She thrived on it. These are the three words that I will take with me when I remember our beloved Vanessa Jade Simone Nelson. Anything you want to say?
Mm-hmm. Thank you again for everyone that's here. Really appreciate your presence. And you're here because you've crossed paths with Vanessa. She was a gift and still is a gift from the Father for us to bring her up in the way that he wanted her to be brought up. She was sent here with an agenda to accomplish so many things. She touched your life. Please keep it in your heart. Your loved ones, hold them tight until you feel it's right to let go. That was her words. Cherish the time that we have together. Don't take it for granted. We are not promised tomorrow. She established her agenda. And the Father said, yes, come back to me, my child. As much as it breaks our heart, the Father is ready for her. As long as we keep her there, she will never be forgotten. Appreciate everyone being here. Love you all. I should love all of you.
No, we're good. No. We're good.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, family and friends. I want to say thank you for being here and for sharing all of your memories and love that you had for my sister. I once wrote a letter asking Vanessa if I could be in her life again, because the thought of losing her felt more real than ever. Now that you're actually gone, I'm so glad that I wrote that letter. In my letter, I said I knew things would not be the same between us, and I believed at that time the closeness that we once shared as young sisters would be forever gone. Little did I know that the women we became apart would make our relationship the best it could have ever been. In the last year, we became the closest that I could have ever imagined. This is why this is so hard, because I feel like I lost you again. But, as you so wisely put it in one of your tweets, I need to remember that there will be constant ebbs and flows in life, and that I will be okay, and that I will get through this. To my children, Caleb, Amaya, and Kane, I know that you are hurting because you lost a bestie, a tanty, and a mother figure. I will honor her memory by being more patient the way she was, more loving and understanding the way she was, and to show you to never give up the way she did. As each day passes, I miss you. But I did see you on this side. And in the right time, I will see you again on the other side. So I leave you with this. Husbands come and go. Children come and eventually they grow. Friends grow up and move away. But the one thing that is never lost is your sister. Thank you.
Thank you, Theo. Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for coming. The worst part, but the best part about things like this is coming together again to see all of you, whether it's been years or not, to know the love is never lost. You guys will show up when it matters. So thank you for being here. Honestly, I feel like I've been thinking about what to say, but I knew at the end of the day I'd still be unprepared. The most consistent and accurate description I've heard of Nessa is how much of a bright light she is. A true example of genuine, authentic energy and excitement for life. One thing about Nessa is that she lived so intentionally and unapologetically. If she wanted, believed, supported, or generally associated herself with anything, it would be done with the absolute best of her ability. It had to be to a T. Nessa never half-assed anything. So as her loved ones, friends, and family, we absolutely owe it to her to live our lives to the fullest, the best of our ability. And I know it sounds cheesy, but it's honest and simple. We do this to honor her as well as ourselves. So in Vanessa's words, I remind myself, I am a goddess. I carry myself in such a way that my presence is felt everywhere I go. My energy vibrates as a frequency only a select few are lucky enough to rock with. Vanessa, I will always love you. And we will never forget who you are and the impact you've had on our lives. Thank you.
Firstly, I would like to say that Vanessa was very happy. So I'm gonna need some smiles. Because we all know Vanessa's smile, A1. But Vanessa Jade Simone Nelson, that name is very impactful to everyone. What's crazier is she hated the name Simone, and I would joke about it with her all the time. And she'd go, Malcolm, you're being such a, I'm not gonna swear, but you get the gist of it. Vanessa was the main character of her story. Didn't take anyone's bull and did what she had to do unapologetically. My favorite story to tell people about her was when I was in grade 2. I had a light purple lunchbox, and every day after school, this bully would come after me, call me names, and put me down. Nessa saw one day, he got to me, and I was crying. She was like, what happened? I told her about it, and she's like, you know what? I'll pick you up from school, and we'll see what we're gonna do about it. I said, okay. 3:30 on the dot, she was there. I point out the bully, and man, she cussed out that bully, man. He was in the car, she was inside the minivan of that car, and told the parent about herself to treat, and this is 17-year-old Vanessa. In that moment, she showed me courage. Don't take anyone's bull, be you. Of course, we bucked heads once in a while. I'm a great brother and all, but some days I have my moments, you know? One day I came home a little late, and she cussed me out about it because it was late and I wasn't answering her phone. We had to talk about it, and she cried and I cried, but she showed me that I can be a caring human being regardless of age. Vanessa was literally a walking life lesson. Every conversation made with her meant something. I'll miss her every day, but I know she's watching over me every day, not giving me any space. And she would hate me if I didn't say Vanessa made the best spaghetti. Vanessa, I am going to miss you and I love you.
Thank you for sharing those amazing memories and also, you know, her inspirational quotes and just idea about life. It's amazing that at 31, you're able to be so impactful in your thought process. These days, I find that, forgive me, but I find that the people are maturing older. You know, from the moment I left home at 18, 19 and went to college, I was on my own. I had to figure life out, kind of a thing. But now I realize that people are leaving home more at 30 than that age, right? So to know that she's 31 and has impacted so many lives with her ideas and her thoughts is just powerful. And she's from that era that is leaving a home a little bit later. And so we're grateful for that. Stand with me, let's sing together this hymn again. How great thou art, that even in the midst of loss and grief and pain, God is still a great God. We talked about his faithfulness, and now we're gonna sing about how great He really is. I think we'll be accompanied again. There we go.
Oh, Lord.
joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration, and then proclaim my God and pray thou.
Verse 25 and 26 says, "And Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he may die, he shall live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Do you believe this?" Please be seated. We'll continue with tributes and reflections from Maurice, Vanessa's husband, and he will be followed by Michael, her brother-in-law.
Hello, everyone, ladies and gentlemen. I want to use this opportunity to say thank you to everyone for being here. Today, we are honoring, celebrating, and remembering Vanessa Jade Simone Nelson. As much as she dislikes me calling her by her government name, especially Simone, my lovely Nessa was a remarkable woman who always held her head high and gave endlessly to those around her. I had an opportunity to share her unique qualities, as well as a ripple effect of positivity and change she created in the world. She is the loveliest woman I've ever met. I admired her poise, her grace, courage, and most importantly, her exceptional beauty. Nessa sets a lasting impression to everyone she comes across, with a stubborn streak that showed up when she sets her mind to do something. Some of us knows where she got that from. Her soft, ridiculous laugh and kind eyes warmed the room and brought life into most boring daily activities. With her passing, Nessa is leaving behind a legacy of kindness, compassion, and generosity. Her love and kindness were infused in everything she did. Whether she was baking, cooking, helping others or working. She had a magical way of bringing joy every time she walked into the room. No one who met her could forget her smile. Nessa was not only my missus, she was my best friend, partner in crime. My everything. And I can't imagine what life is going to be like without her. She shared good humor and a big smile with everything she met. Even though I often cursed her practical jokes, and she goes on to me, rude, giving me the evils with her eye, they were very pretty. Nessa has got a way to make every person feel like they were the most important person in the world. She's gifted like that. Despite all the personal challenges, she always looked outside herself, which is why she would be remembered as a beacon of light in this marketplace we call world. When times were difficult, we call it serious times, she could always put a smile on my face or anyone going through a pickle. She held her head so high until the end, showing what it looks like to finish strong. With Nessa's passing, she leaves behind a legacy of kindness, compassion, and generosity. We both are from two separate work backgrounds. We complemented each other perfectly. We got on like a house on fire. Anyone who met Ness quickly learned that there's always a laugh to be shared. It was impossible to spend time with her without enjoying a gut-bursting laugh at some point in the conversation. Our courtship was difficult, as we had to overcome the bloody pandemic. But I was determined to make her my wife. I remembered how beautiful she looked walking down the aisle at our wedding. Her big brown eyes, her cheeks flushed with excitement. But moms and pops beside her as proud as punch. I've got a little poem to say. I sit and wait as the time goes by, unable to find my escape from grief. I glance at the clock only to find many hours to go before relief. Discomforts I seek from emotions so stark that I hope to find in the arms of sleep seems to elude my frantic grasp in the dark. And my only choice is to wait and weep. The crushing weight of being alone is only lifted when my slumber comes. Even then, my subconscious groans as even my dreams realize she's gone. So this is my life, day and night, always laden with the heavy sadness. There is no way my heart will ever be right, and my mind sinks evermore into madness. Nessa, my beautiful, sweet, darling wife, may you be at peace, and Yeshua bless you. I will miss you, Ness. I will always hold on to the amazing memories we shared together. Thank you for your infinite love that will help me through each day. And thank you for the memories we would never fade away. I'm proud to be your husband, your own customized Idris Elba. And every day, in some small way, we will celebrate your life. As long as memory lasts, you will stay in our hearts, your loving husband. Thank you.
There's a lot I've written here, but I don't think I'll say most of it. I remember the first day I met Ness. She was the lead supervisor at a place I was applying for a job, and she hired me. And from the interview, we hit it off. You know what I mean? I knew it was going to be something special. Years later, you know, Mom told me recently that from that very first day that she met me, she wanted me to be a part of the family. She chose me for her sister. You know what I mean? And she knew from the get-go, we're engaged now, you know? And it was just so interesting our chemistry from the beginning, you know? And recently, in this last year, we're getting so much closer, you know? And I think that's the case with so many of us. You know, for me, one of my favorite things about her was her realness. She was genuine, she was authentic, she was honest. You could trust her. You know, to me, that epitomizes the essence of God. She was just rawly real. She was one of one. You cannot replicate that. I'm looking at the words I wrote, and they don't hold the weight I need them to hold. So I'm not even going. I'm just so grateful to be a part of this family. I'm so grateful that she chose me to be here. I'm grateful that I got to know her, to meet her. I'm grateful that I got to love her, you know? And I think one of the things I'll miss most about her is the side of her family that she brings out, you know? I read a quote that says, a different version of you exists in the mind of everyone you know, whether it's your friends or your family, you know? But anytime she was with her family, there was always a different side, you know what I mean? I'm going to miss that, you know? Vanessa, I love you. I miss you. And I thank you. I'm grateful. And one thing I'll leave you guys with is, you've heard it, all of us have said it, she's intentional. Anything that was she deemed as urgent, she addressed it. You know what I mean? She wasn't afraid to tell you if she never liked you. She wasn't afraid to tell you. She wasn't necessarily confrontational, but she never shied away from a difficult conversation. That's real courage. You know what I mean? So if you're here, you mean something to her or her family. Honor her by being more intentional with the way you live. Thank you.
Thank you for speaking from the heart, both of you who shared. You know, grieving is so unique and different for different people. To feel different, it feels different for the parents than it does for a husband. But it all equates and equals to the pain and the grief that you feel in a time of loss, and you really don't even know what will happen next. Tomorrow you don't know how you will feel when you wake up. But it's the reality of what we deal with. So you see in your program that we have a little slot to give a few folks a chance to say something. Now, this is going to be very controlled. Might I just add that disclaimer? So we're going to start off with three people at most, and then see where we end up from there. Maximum of 2 minutes you're going to share. And if you're going over your 2 minutes, you will just hear me trying to sing in the background, and I don't sing very well. So if you wish to speak, may I just ask you to stand right now? Three of you, just stand, so I know that we will have three people. If you so desire as of speaking and to share your memories of Vanessa, may I invite you to stand? Just stand where you are. One, come on up, sir. Just come on while you're standing there. Thank you. You don't have to bring the chair with you, all right? You can leave the chair. Anybody else wish to share in this service? Come on, sir. Come on and just have a seat up at the front here. Thank you. Going once, going twice, there's a young lady coming. Come on up and just have a seat up the front there. So thank you very much. These are the three folks that will share. Thank you.
I'm Vanessa's uncle, and I'm just going to be short and sweet, because I remember Vanessa is short and sweet. One day, when I was babysitting, she hugged me and just buried herself in my neck, and she pulled away and said, "Uncle Glenn, you smell like candy." And it wasn't up until now that I see the full circle of life, because the entrepreneur that Vanessa is sent me some candles, and I haven't lit it yet, and I now know why. It's because Vanessa is light that will live on, and it also smells just like candy. So Vanessa, keep being sweet, and as my brother Dwight says, everyone, cherish each other, hug them, bury yourself within their neck, and hold them, because life is short and sweet. Love you, Vanessa.
It's a little difficult being here right now, but like everybody said, Nessa was a light. She was a positive light in every room she stepped into. And you couldn't miss her. As soon as she smiled, that gap. That was the first thing you saw. When I met Nessa, it was a certain point in my life where I didn't think I was worth doing anything. I saw her as a role model, as a leader, as a coach, because she saw in me what I didn't see in myself as yet. And she pushed. I know there's a lot of people in here that she's pushed you to be the best person that you could be. So hold on to that. Nessa, baby. We were supposed to get all a drink on the porch, girl. But I know you're still with us. And your memory will live on. and we will cherish it every day. I encourage everyone to live intentionally, because she did every day, regardless or not if she wanted to. And that made a difference. We need more people like her in the world. Love you.
My name is Chevy, for those who don't know. I met Vanessa about 5 years ago working at Whole Foods, and I couldn't tell you the day that we met. I felt like we were like this from day one, even with her family. You guys welcomed us with open arms anytime we see you, and I thank you for that. The gift that you guys gave the world was the sun. She loved us, she warmed us, she encouraged us, she helped us all grow, and I thank you. I thank you, you guys did an amazing job. And for her, for you guys doing an amazing job with her, she has now done that for us. So we're gonna continue to shine and be bright and live in the excellence that she has all allowed us to elevate to. I thank you from the bottom of my heart. I love you guys all, Vanessa, my queen. My queen, I will forever say Grand Rise and see you every morning. And I'll always hold myself accountable the way you did for me. I thank you and I love you. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Bobby. I'm a cousin of the family, Bassett Ridge side. I just want to take a moment. Unfortunately, we only see family and weddings and funerals. It's sad, but can't have a personal experience with Vanessa. But one thing I love right off the bat, my wife can test. If we had a daughter, I wanted to name her Vanessa so I could say, Nessa! And I love that. But what I want to share is, not too long ago, my brother passed away in the same. We had the funeral right here. And one thing I want to share with you is that certain qualities you talked about, Vanessa, how she brightens up a room and makes everyone smile, that's something I saw in my brother. And I just want to tell you that in time it heals a little bit, but try to remember those moments you guys said. It's going to be hard. I won't tell you there's a day I won't want to break down and lose it. He was my man. When I came to wrestling, I wanted something to know. I called Donnie. I can't pick up that phone no more and talk to him, but what I could tell you, you put God first, and you remember all the good stuff. And remember the hard stuff with her, and God will heal you a little bit. That hole in your heart closes just a little bit, but I just want to let you know you do heal. So again, God bless all of you, and thank you.
Let me thank all those who shared in this segment of Open Tribute, and for sharing, and for all my friends just nicely sneaked in there. Thank you very much, though, for respecting time and for sharing your thoughts. As I thought about what to share in this service, thinking about a 31 years old young lady who got married in December of 2021, having a full life ahead of her with great potential. And I realized that so many of us, especially young people, who think that we're seemingly healthy, and of course, the adults, we tend to have this feeling as if we control life. We fall asleep and we wake up without thinking. and we drive out and we drive back home and we walk down the road with the dog. We walk back home and we feel as if we are in control, because that's what it feels like. My family and I, we were off for about 5 weeks with some business involved in there. And so my four-year-old, she's been home with mom, while my six-year-old, she goes to school. And so during the weekdays, they know that they would see me in the evenings. And on weekends, we go to church together on Sunday, but some Saturdays I'm out like this. And so when we got to spend that 5 weeks together, they woke up with me every morning. They saw me through the day, and we went to bed together and woke up in the morning. I was there again. So when it was time for me to go back to the office, and I was walking out the door that morning, my daughters were like, "Where are you going?" And I'm saying, "I'm going to work." They were like, "No, you're not going to work. Like, we spent the last 5 weeks together, but I have to go back to work." And my four-year-old looked at me and she asked me this question. She said, "Daddy, are you coming home?" And I said yes to her. But then I went in the car, and that question was just ringing in my ears, not realizing what she was really asking me, but she was asking me, "Are you coming back home soon?" But the way she asked the question, "Are you coming home?" And on my way to the office, my honest answer to that question is in my head is that I don't know. I do not know that I'll make it home at the end of the day, for different reasons. And so, instead of taking this life that we have for granted, let's value the life that we have. Why should we value the life that we have? The psalmist in Psalm 39, verse 4 down says, "Lord, make me know my end. And what is the measure of my days, that I may know how frail I am? Indeed, you have made my days as handbreadth, and my age is nothing before you." Now, this is the part that gets me. "Certainly, every man at his best state is a vapor." Every man at his or her best state, at your healthiest moment, you're just a vapor. Think about water that becomes gas. You're boiling something on the stove. That steam that you see coming from that is that vapor. You can't hold it. You can touch it. You can feel it on your skin. But 1 minute you see it there, 1 second you see it there, and the next second it's gone. The psalmist says, my life is frail. It's nothing before you. And my life is just like a vapor at my healthiest state, at my best, when things are running, when I'm at my career high, and I don't have to go to see the doctor but for my annual. My children are well, my spouse is well, it's all together. I'm not in any debt, I'm fine. The psalmist says, at that state, you and I are just a vapor. That one moment it's there, and the next moment is gone. So since we're realizing that now, what do we do? What do we do with the time that we're vapor? What impact will we have? What will the tribute sound like on a day like this? At my funeral, at your funeral. Because believe me, there will be a funeral. It could be next week, could be next 10 years, could be another 20 years. And I'm not talking about you, I'm talking about me. Because I know you're not gonna die, right? But the reality is, all of us will experience death. Therefore, Dwight says it best, that while we are alive, Jesus was asked a question. They asked Jesus, of all the commandments, which are the greatest? Jesus replied, love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, with all your mind, with everything. But the second is as the first, love your neighbor as yourself. Therefore, while this vapor is hanging around, before it dissipates, before it vanishes, before it disappears and is no more, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with everything. Give him everything. But the next thing that is equally important is that you love the people around you. Why is that so? I know some people are trying to see me over here, so let me walk over here a little bit. It's because God says you are a hypocrite. If you say that you love me, that you cannot see, and hate your brother that you can see. Therefore, before you can say you truly love me, God, you must love your neighbor as yourself. And so, because we're vanishing, because every day that we're alive, we're dying, because every moment we are around, we don't know if I will go home this afternoon. The people that are around you, let's hold on to them. Let's love them. Let's forgive them. I like the thing that one of her sisters said, that she wrote a letter to her, and last year was just the best year of their sibling lives. They were getting closer. It's fine, we have our issues. Let's forgive each other. Let's call up somebody this afternoon and say, I'm sorry. Can we meet up? Let's love on each other. But while we're loving on the people around us, let's remember to love God, who's the creator of all of this. Because the writer says it best. When Job captured his story, in Job chapter 1, when he says, the Lord giveth, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Therefore, as I close, while we go to work in the daytime and we get back home and we fall asleep in the nighttime and we wake back up and we take the dog for the walk or we go to the gym or we do things, he is still in control, and we don't control life. Because he gives life, and it is appointed unto man, once to die, he will take it away back from us. He will take it back away from us. And we have no control over it. Share this story with you, and I close, and I pray. Just last Sunday, a family whose mom doing so well, the doctor says, call everybody together, since you've taken the decision to take her off the ventilator. and I went after dinner on Sunday to meet with the family at the hospital. They removed her from the ventilator, and I went back into the room with the family after that was done. And I could watch the family. Before we went out, we pray for the Lord's will to be done. We went back in there and I could watch the children just waiting for that last breath. And when I realized that's what they were doing, I said to them, the doctors may have said one thing, but they cannot tell you when she will go, because they do not control that. It's almost 1 week later, she's out of the ICU, she's on the regular ward, and she's back to 90% breathing. That's just showing you an example of the fact that we don't control it, they don't control it, but God is the one who controls this life. We just live it. Therefore, since that's what we have control over, let's live a good life. Amen. I'm going to ask the parents and the siblings and husband and the spouse, just join me right here if you are okay with that, just right at the front of right here. Yes, right here. It's right, just kind of smack it in the middle, just come right around. I know it's rough, I know it's difficult, I know it's not going to be an easy journey from here out. The reality is, this is our last moment with Vanessa in this form. However, God is so gracious and merciful that I will tell people, as a pastor, I will never go to a funeral and make prediction of where people are going. That's not my job. It's God's job. But we mourn with hope that one day we'll see her again. We'll get to spend a life with her that is endless and that has no pain. And that's the hope that you mourn with. That's the hope that you have. But that hope is only found in Jesus. Lord, we thank you for a mother and a father who brought a beautiful baby girl into this world and watched her grow for 31 years. Theirs are the challenges and the pain of watching her leaving them. God, I can imagine the joy that they experienced in that labor room when she came into this world. But today we all witness the pain that they feel in letting her go. With her siblings around them and her husband rigged with pain, I pray for strength, God, that man can't give. Holy Spirit, you'll bring them peace, comfort, and strength. That you'll cover this family under your blood, God, in a powerful way. That, Jesus, they will not live in fear of this happening to them at an early age. They will not live in fear of, I wonder if this will happen to me. But they will live in faith, knowing that you're in control of their lives. God cover their mind under your blood. Cover their lives under your blood. And I pray that as they allow our memory to be a strong part of their lives, that you'd be with them. There are people in this congregation who are equally close to her as her very biological family. They're mourning, they're in pain to God. Strengthen them and give them peace. I pray for a husband who read words that express the difficulties that he has to be alone. That you be his strength and his fortress. You promise to be a very present help in times of trouble. So be with him now, we pray. Lord, I thank you for the life that Vanessa, Jade, Simone, Nelson lived. Thank you for the impact that she had. Thank you, God, that she's left many lives better. I commit her spirit to you even now, God. And wherever her remains will lie on this earth, that she will find peace with you. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you very much. You may be seated. Thank you very much for coming today. Thank you for allowing me to serve your family in this very difficult time. I know it's not an easy one, but together we'll make it. I'm going to ask you to stay in your seats. The funeral director will be coming at this time to give us some instructions. And we will follow accordingly in an orderly manner. Thank you very much for allowing me to share with you in this service. And thank you for being an awesome audience.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. As this concludes the service for Vanessa, I would like to thank everyone in attendance here today, as well as those that are currently joining us on the live stream. As a private cremation will take place, I do again want to thank everyone for coming and supporting the family during this time. And as we leave the chapel here today, we'll have Pastor lead us out, followed by the casket and family and friends falling in behind. And lastly, I just want to say on behalf of myself, Angel Robinson, and the New Haven family, we'd like to thank you for allowing us to serve you. If you're able, please rise.